It takes more than 4,000 newtons of force to break the femur, which is the strongest bone in your body. That's close to 400 kilograms of weight. So with that in mind, it's easy to understand the enormous amount of pressure your bones can withstand. Apply more pressure than that, though, and you end up breaking a bone. If you've gone through this, then you know how painful it can be. But did you ever wonder how exactly a bone heals and regains its strength? Today, Bestie is here to tell you about the way bone fractures are treated and the science behind the three stages of the bone healing process. To help you heal faster in case of a fracture, we'll give you some healthy tips too. So grab your helmet as we take you on this ride. Safety first, we don't want you to end up with any broken bones. Medically termed as a fracture, a bone break can be complete or partial. Whether it needs surgery or a metal plate or just a brace for healing all depends on how bad the break is. The bone should heal in a way that stays true to its natural anatomy. A bone that heals in an unusual position will likely have to be broken again, which doesn't sound like a picnic. Not to mention, if it heals incorrectly, it can lead to abnormal bleeding, clotting, infection, muscle damage, and swelling around the affected area. Some bones, such as your thigh bone, can take longer to heal. They might experience fat embolism too, which is when fat globules are released into the bloodstream and end up where they shouldn't. Not something you want to happen, that's for sure. So it's extremely important to consult a doctor in case of a fracture. Sitting at home and self-medicating can cause irreversible damage or something much worse. So avoiding the doctor is a no-no. When you do talk to a doctor, depending on the location and how bad the fracture is, you'll be recommended a specific treatment. If you have a minor fracture like a hairline one, that can heal on its own. You'll likely be given a traditional cast, like the ones all the kids used to sign in school. A fiberglass cast or a plaster one makes the broken bone immobile and is the usual treatment for fractures of the foot, arm, leg, and wrist bones. If absolute immobility isn't required, a doctor can also put you in a functional cast or brace. This one gives you limited control and movement. Usually, you'll be first given a traditional plaster cast and then a brace. This way, you step up from absolutely no movement to a little movement gradually. In case you've had a serious accident that left you with a more complicated or serious break, the doctors will perform a special surgery known as a reduction. In this procedure, they'll expose and reposition your bone so it can heal properly. The open reduction also uses tools or fixations like metal rods and special screws. So basically, you'll become part robot. Now that the broken bone is set in place, the healing can begin. It happens in three crucial stages. Stage 1, the inflammatory phase. The first stage of healing starts immediately after you break a bone. It's also called hematoma formation. 48 hours after the fracture, the blood is released by vessels around the affected area. Eventually, this blood forms a hematoma, which leads to the disruption of blood supply to the bone. Without blood, bone cells around the fracture die. This goes on for about a week before the next stage of healing starts. Stage number 2, the repairing phase. As the name suggests, this is the phase where the actual bone repair happens. It lasts for about 2 to 3 weeks after the fracture and is the time when the body first develops tissue and cartilage around the break. If the bone is broken completely, a soft tissue collar starts forming on both ends of the broken bone. This growth will continue until there's a bridge formed between the two broken ends. Kinda neat, huh? This bridge is called a callus, and it helps in stabilizing the broken ends. As time passes, this tissue callus will be replaced by a bony callus, made up of spongy bone. This newly formed bony callus will be called trabecular bone, and once this happens, the final stage of the healing process starts. Stage 3. Bone remodeling. The third and final process of the bone repair replaces the spongy callus we just talked about with a hard, solid bone. Unfortunately, this takes a long time to happen and can go on for several months. The compaction of a newly formed bone continues until it returns to its original state. Blood circulation will continue to improve as you regain the use of the limb that was broken with everyday weight and activity. It typically takes around 6 to 8 weeks for these three steps to be completed. Normally, you'll be able to do regular activities and stop feeling any pain much before that, though the healing time is different for everyone and depends on the type of fracture. No matter how simple the healing process sounds, many things can slow it down. Weight bearing too soon can break immature bone fragments. So when the doctor tells you to take it easy, it's best to listen to their advice. You should try to avoid smoking too, as it can constrict blood circulation to the affected area. Also, medical conditions like diabetes or certain medications can slow down the healing process as well. Make sure you check with your doctor, as everyone is different. To help you heal faster alongside your treatment, we have a few healthy tips for you. You can boost your bone healing by giving it what it needs most, protein. Protein deficiency can make the callus formed around the fracture rubbery instead of solid. The bone's major component is protein, so make sure you get lots of it in your diet from food or supplements. Certain antioxidants can prevent tissue damage during the healing by removing free radicals from your body. So make foods like berries, kale, spinach, and dark chocolate part of your diet. They are filled with those amazing antioxidants your body needs. Apart from protein, bones also require minerals. Calcium, magnesium, silicon, phosphorus, and zinc are all crucial for bone repair. So turn to foods like salmon, potatoes, and egg yolks to take care of your mineral needs. These minerals specifically help the formation of callus and will help speed up the healing process. Now, you might have the raw material for bone formation in the form of protein and minerals, but most body interactions need vitamins. This is why multivitamin supplements are recommended for stronger bones, because bone rebuilding needs them. Vitamin B is essential for energy production, and similarly, other vitamins like C, K, D, and E play a significant role in accelerating the bone rebuilding. So your meals should include foods like broccoli, squash, citrus fruits, and carrots, as they are rich in vitamins. Apart from these foods, you can also go for herbal supplements. However, we recommend you talk to your doctor before taking them alongside your regular medicine. Soon, you'll need to get moving again. Once you've been given the okay, physiotherapy can really help in certain cases. Exercise improves blood flow to the site of injury, and proper exercising can help the patient regain the limb function too. This part can be a bit uncomfortable, but it's a necessary part of the healing process. Whichever way you end up breaking a bone, be mindful about the amount of pressure you're putting on it. Immobilization is the most important part of healing, so don't go jumping around until your doctor allows you to. The main focus should be to take it slow and give the body the time it needs to heal. Have you ever broken a bone? How many have you broken? Let us know in the comments section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.